for another brand new day when we can give him praise and glory and honor, for he deserves it. He alone is worthy of our praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God, for another day. Thank you, Lord God, for the privilege to be here at JGRFM to deliver a word of encouragement, Lord God. Father, I thank you for your many blessings. I thank you, Lord, for watching over us, for keeping us, God. I thank you, Lord God, for your manifest presence. And I thank you, Lord God, for answered prayer on behalf of this Joy Gospel Radio FM family. Thank you, Lord God, for those that have received healing. Thank you, Lord, for those that have soundness of mind, those that have received peace, Lord God. Father, we thank you and we praise you because you are the Almighty God and you hear and you answer prayer. Father, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. I'm reading this morning from Luke chapter 7, verses 36 to 39. Luke 7, 36 to 39. Then one of the Pharisees asked him to eat with him, and he went to the Pharisee's house and sat down to eat. And behold, a woman in the city who was a sinner, when she knew that Jesus sat at the table in the Pharisee's house, brought an alabaster flask of fragrant oil and stood at his feet behind him weeping. And she began to wash his feet with her tears and wiped them with the hair of her head. And she kissed his feet and anointed them with the fragrant oil. The title of this devotion is Set Your Focus on Jesus. Set your focus on Jesus. The scripture tells us that Jesus went into the Pharisee's house and he sat down to eat. Based on the custom in those days, the women were not allowed to eat with the men, so we presume that there were only men in the room. No other women were mentioned either. There was a certain woman who heard that Jesus was there, and she went in uninvited because she wanted to be in his presence. She wanted to anoint him and she wanted to worship him. So regardless of what people might have said about her, she made her way to get into the presence of Jesus. She did not mind who was watching her, who was talking about her, who deemed that she was unworthy. She disregarded the murmuring because her focus was on Jesus. You see, some people will not worship God, but they will criticize those who do. When we worship God, we focus on Him alone. We may be aware of what people think of us, what they say about us, but because our focus is on worshiping God, we come before Him without anger, we come without envy, we come without jealousy, we come without bitterness or resentment. We come without compassion. We come into his presence to worship him with a pure heart and clean hands. When this woman began to worship the King of Kings, the atmosphere shifted. All eyes were on Jesus, looking to see how he would react to the sinner in their midst. Jesus does not see people as we do. He sees the heart that we cannot see. They looked at her and they decided she is a sinner. Why is she here? Oh God. And if he was a prophet, he would know who this woman is that is touching him because she is a sinner. Hallelujah, God. Jesus said in his word, he did not come to save the righteous, but bring sinners to repentance. Jesus loved sinners so much that he died to save us. We were not born saved. We were sinners and we committed sin. But for the grace and mercy of a loving God, we are children of God. When we realize and experience God's love, his mercy and his grace, we are hungry to be in his presence just to worship him, to worship him alone. Regardless of what people might say, we focus on God. You see, pure worship shifts the atmosphere, and we wait for God's reaction. Because when we worship, hallelujah, God will show his mercy toward us. Spiritual hunger shifts the atmosphere. This woman wanted to be in Jesus' presence, regardless of the customs and the religious tradition. She humbled herself before Jesus. Humility shifts the atmosphere. The scripture says that God will view the proud afar off. But humility, hallelujah, will shift the atmosphere when we get into his presence. This woman wasn't ashamed of her tears. She had so much tears that they could wash Jesus' feet. Hallelujah. It was against the custom for her to be uncovered, for her hair to be uncovered. But she wasn't ashamed to dry his feet with her hair. Apply costly perfume on his feet and kiss his feet. What an extravagant act of worship. She gave him everything that she had. In the midst of the critics, she bowed, hallelujah, in his presence. She honored Jesus in the presence of the skeptics, and his attention shifted to her. The men in the room criticized her for her act of worship. They criticized Jesus for not recognizing the type of woman that she was. She had several strikes against her. She wasn't invited. She was a woman, and she was a sinner. She wasn't supposed to be there. Some people will look at you and say, you're not supposed to. You're not supposed to worship. You're not worthy to worship. You're not worthy to go in his presence. But your hunger, hallelujah, just like this woman, will take you into his presence. She had a hunger and a desire for his presence. And her desire was to honor him. Some people may discourage you from going to certain places. But if Jesus is there, forget about the customs and the religious, hallelujah. The religious customs, and make your way into his presence. Her worship was unacceptable to them, but her worship moved Jesus. Don't let anyone tell you that you are not worthy to worship God. You know your heart. You know your desire, and God sees your desire. God wants true worshipers. Worship him in spirit and in truth. Worship him with your whole being. Jesus shifted his focus onto the woman who was worshiping him. He said to her, your sins are forgiven. And immediately the man wanted to know, who is he that he can forgive sins? And then he said to her, he went even further, and he said to her, not to anyone else, not to any of the other men, any of the men who were in the room. He looked at the one who worshiped. Hallelujah. He looked at the one who gave him her all. And he said to her, your faith has saved you. Go in peace. When your worship shifts the atmosphere, God focuses his attention to you. When we minister to him, he in turn ministers to us. When the atmosphere shifts, we lose control. Our program is no longer important. When the atmosphere shifts, the Holy Spirit is in control and chains are broken. Situations change when the heavens are opened. Hallelujah. We don't leave the same way that we came. Her tomorrow was surely greater than her today. She entered a sinner whom the men criticized, but she left delivered because her worship was focused on the Savior. Who are you focusing on today? Where is your worship? Ah, God, has your worship stopped because of the critics? Has your worship stopped because of something somebody said or did to you? Has your worship stopped because somebody condemned you? Jesus is looking to you. He will turn his attention to you when you bow down and worship him and give him your all in spite of the situation. We are here to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Don't let anyone stop your worship. As a matter of fact, in the face of opposition, choose to worship him even more. Let us focus our worship on God alone, and his attention will be turned toward us. Heavenly Father, I thank you this morning for this word that you have given, Father. It's a message for someone of us this morning, mighty God. Because somebody this morning has held back their worship because you thought that you were unworthy. Because somebody told you that you are not worthy to worship. Come into his presence this morning. Give him your all. God sees your heart. He knows your desire. Bow down and worship him. His attention will be turned toward you, and your tomorrow will be greater than today. Father, thank you this morning for healing of mind and body. You are God alone. Besides you, there is no savior. There is no deliverer. So we worship you, God. We bow in your bosha. We bow in your presence and we worship you. You alone are worthy of our worship. To God be the glory. Great things he has done. The Lord bless you this morning. Have a wonderful weekend.